value to yourself and realign yourself for your behaviors, for business, for love, or for any relationship or health. See the environment. Everything develops into the particular environment. If it is a business, then see the environment. Is there any environment for the business where you can grow, we can develop the thoughts and people get the energy to work? When there is a thinking for development, multiplying into 5, 10, 20 times, having new ideas, is there an environment? Because if you want to develop apples, you cannot develop in desert. Some particular environment, temperature, air required for it. Then whatever you are doing, again review it for your behaviors. If you want to achieve something and you are not getting the desired result, then we need to review our behaviors. Behaviors means our actions, what we do since morning to evening. How we live our day, those are the behaviors, those are the actions to be checked. So, if we are achieving something, we have some goal in our mind and we are not getting the desired results, we need to see that what we are doing to achieve it. Those are the behaviors. See, any of your behavior, you find it is not aligned with the goal, activities you are going to achieve. So, if you see your behaviors, align your behaviors, the next level is of your resources and capabilities. You see your capabilities and see your results, you will find the gap. Something you are capable of and you are getting. So, if you see that you are not utilizing your 100% resources, then how you will get the 100% results? You are capable of doing many things. You are capable of doing wonders, but if you are not utilizing your resources, you see the quality of your resources you are applying, and those will help you to achieve your results. The next level is beliefs and values. Something you value, you will get it. Most of the time, we talk about the money, but we say, what will happen if you get money? People get spoiled by money. So if we don't have the right values for the money, then money will not come to us. If we don't value health, if we don't value relationship, so something you don't value will not come to you. So change those values. Change those values which you want to have. Then your own beliefs may be the hurdles. If you have limiting beliefs, then change, break those limits which tells you it is possible, it is not possible. Change all limiting beliefs inside. There are two types of beliefs, implicit and explicit. The implicit belief is lying in our subconscious mind which you have experienced with your education, association, environment, with your long years of experience. So change all those beliefs which are stopping your success, and those are called limiting beliefs. Then next is your identification. If you are not clear about your identity, then identity crisis will stop your success. Be clear, be sure of your identity. How you want to look like, how people should see you, how people should recognize you is your identity. Today, if you go into the society, then how you want to see yourself, people should recognize you, is your clear identity. In absence of your identity, you don't know what is to be done next. To get a crystal clear identity. Identity crisis is one of the biggest reasons for failures. To get your new identity. How you want to be recognized in the society, how you want that people should know you, that is your identity. And next is purpose, beyond yourself. If you are here, if you have taken birth, if God has sent you, then there must be some specific purpose for coming to learn. So find out some specific purpose for yourself. Now, if we realign them, all these behaviors, then first find out the specific purpose for yourself. It may be related to society, education, religion, for health, or anything you want to do for the people, where you want to contribute and help the people to grow, achieve their dreams, achieve their life, better their life, can be one of the purpose. Then with this purpose, create your new identity and let the people know. If you want to print your visiting card, then what will be your one role identity on this visiting card? How people should know you? That is your identity. And post-identity, create those new beliefs, break all those beliefs which are stopping, which are hurdles, create new beliefs, create new values, redesign new values, and next, find out your new capabilities, develop those new capabilities. If something is required to be newly acquired, then learn those new skills and develop your resources, utilize those resources, make 100% use of resources which you are capable of. Everything is hidden and lying inside you. Only you will only use those resources. And you don't need anything from outside, because everything is inside. Decision you will take, learning you will make. And after this, there are behaviors. Ask yourself, which behaviors are helping you and which behaviors are threat to your life, threat to your career, threat to your social life, threat to your religious life, threat to your professional life. Change all those behaviors. Review your actions for the day. If you review your last week, you can easily find out that how many hours are productive and how many hours we have wasted. Which are the behaviors are helping in your health? Which are the behaviors helping in your religious life, in your social life, in your professional, in your career? Change all those behaviors. Create new behaviors. And lastly, environment. Everything is the product of its own environment. To create a new environment, change the environment where anything can grow. Your happiness, your peace, your prosperity, your health. Create that wonderful environment, because you have this, all those capabilities, resources, behaviors. You can change that. And if you change your environment, align those six behaviors, then success will follow you. Life will change and life will never be same again. Thank you, sir.